friends. I'm back with another yin class for you today. I'm calling it Feelgood Friday Yin because, well, it's Friday when I'm filming this. And the series of poses that I've chosen all feel really good to me. I totally understand that that is a relative thing. But I hope that at least for you, most of this feels pretty nice. I'm for sure going to use a yoga block in a specific way, so make sure that you at least have one yoga block. I'm also going to use a bolster for my own comfort in lots of different positions. So if you have that, go ahead and grab it. If you don't have that, I would just probably grab maybe a blanket of some kind, maybe some pillows from your sofa or your bed, just to make sure that you have enough support at your disposal. Okay, so let's come down to our backs. And from here, we're gonna start with a supported bridge pose, and we're gonna start with the block on the very lowest height, just to let things get acclimated for a moment. So I'm going to lift my hips up, slide the block underneath, and then rest on the block. And the sacrum should be there because you're on that widest flat part. It might, cover a little bit more ground than when it's at different heights. And I would just think this feels absolutely wonderful. So we'll take a moment in this position just to let things kind of settle into that shape. Taking some nice, slow, deep breaths. In and out through your nose with your breath. Maybe some exhaling through the mouth feels nice too. Hands could be on your belly like mine are, just to kind of watch that rise and fall to your breath. Maybe you want arms beside you, just resting down, arms overhead. Maybe try a few different positions and see what feels best. So from here, you can absolutely stay in this base position. If you want to try taking your block up a little bit higher, that's where I'm gonna go next. I'm gonna take it up to the medium height. So you'll have to get your hands on the block and then press into your feet to lift the hips, and then take the block one height up and then settle back down onto it with your sacrum. So a little bit lower probably than you think, and you may have to adjust a little bit there. Hopefully that still feels pretty nice. If it's too much, come back down to that low setting. So from here, we're going to try a couple of different stretches. I'm going to lift my right foot and grab behind the right knee, releasing the left leg all the way down, and then kind of pulling a little bit on the right leg. Okay, I'm gonna keep my left leg in place, and then I'm gonna just keep my right knee bent as I take that foot down and hang out
here. Let the left leg extended, feeling some hip extension on that side. Make sure that your back feels okay. You can adjust that block a little bit higher or lower depending on how your back is feeling. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and bend the left knee and take that foot back down. Take a moment there. All right, and this time I'll grab behind the left knee, release the right leg all the way down. Give a little pull on the left leg. Breathe. Keep the right leg extended and take the left foot down with that knee bent. And we'll hang out here for a little bit, feeling that nice hip extension through the right side. One more breath here. Okay, I'm gonna take my right leg back in, so both feet are down, knees are bent. Take a moment or two. Okay, gonna take a hand to that block. Press into the feet, lift the hips up off of the block, slide the block out, lower all the way down to your back, take your time. And then once your back is settled down into your mat, let's just do a little bit of movement to sort of reset that area, a little bit of pelvic tilting. Hips will stay down, right? We'll let the low back lift so there's a little arch to the back, and then exhale, press it flat. Inhale, exhale. So just a few more times. Okay. I'm going to extend my legs down and reach arms overhead, but you could do something different with your arms as needed. I'm gonna move into banana pose next, a nice side body stretch. Take both legs and scoot them over to the right. And then a little upper body shimmy or scoot in that direction, keeping hips down and shoulders down. So if your shoulders are feeling a little too put upon, you might bend your elbows more and kind of take your arms more out than up. That's one way to kind of adjust that. You could experiment with ankles crossed. Things might feel a little bit like more of the stretch if you cross your left ankle over the right ankle. You can do a little bit less by crossing. crossing right over left. And maybe you do a little bit of both. So the pose is like it sounds, right? We're in a sort of banana-like, crescent-like shape. Feeling some good length down left side body. Probably feeling a little in that hip as well, on the front side of the hip. Maybe a little bit in the lower back, depending. You can turn your head any which way you like. Maybe try a few different positions. Take a couple more deep breaths on this side. Okay, so to come out of banana pose, I like to move one half of my body at a time. So you might just kind of scoot your upper body back to center first, and then if you've got your ankles crossed, uncross, and then scoot your legs back to center. Take a moment between sides, and as you're ready, you can switch to the other side, scooting over to the left, the legs, and the upper body kind of scoots over. Arms reach up or out, bend your elbows if that feels better, or shoulders. Maybe an ankle cross. You can try that both ways. Make sure that you're still lying down. You're not on your side. Check your hips and shoulders. And breathe. few more deep breaths here on the side. Scooching one half back to center, uncrossing, scooching the legs. All right, you might give your knees a hug from here and just rock a little bit, side to side. All right, you can roll over to one side and then press up to seat it. Here, from seated, I'm going to have feet out in front of me with knees bent, and you can just kind of rest on your hands. And we're going to do a little bit of windshield wiper from side to side with the legs. And then we'll get a set up for our next position. So I'm going to keep my legs windshield wipered, making that a verb, over to the right. And I'm going to just kind of scoop the feet in a little bit more. So this is a deer pose setup. And to start from seated, I'm going to add a little bit of a neck stretch to the mix. All right, so I'm going to let my right ear drop toward the right shoulder. Reaching right hand up and over. See if you can kind of grab behind your left ear. Give a little tug, right? And then we're gonna take the back of the left hand behind the back, sort of on the lower back area. Might feel a little bit in your shoulder. You might have to adjust your head position a little bit just to find a good spot. Stretch, and then we're going to go into a forward fold from here with deer pose legs, and I'm going to use my bolster to rest on. You don't necessarily have to rest on anything. You can have whatever you want out in front of you, but basically we're just going to kind of lean forward a little bit and rest here for a moment or two. You might put your head down on a prop. Deep breaths.
Remember, you can adjust the height of your props by stacking things. You can stack your hands
if that helps too, if you need a little bit more height. As you get into the folded position, as opposed to the seated position,
you might feel like you need to adjust the angle of your legs a little bit, and all that stuff is okay.
All right, there's a lot of wiggle room in these yin poses to suit your needs, to fit your body, so don't be afraid to experiment until it feels better. here.
Somewhat as is, but I'm going to scoot it a little bit closer in, and that's going to be my half saddle leg. If you need to keep yours a little bit wider, that is absolutely fine. You got to do what your knee will tolerate. And this other leg, you could just have your knee up with your foot down, or you can extend it forward. Right? So if you are coming into this seated position and feel like your hips are having trouble settling all the way down, maybe grab a blanket or a pillow to sit on. And then from here, regardless of your exact leg setup, what we're gonna try to do is lean back a bit. So recline a bit. I'm gonna use a bolster behind me. You could prop that up as high as you need to, right? You can go all the way down on your back if you're a little bit flexier and that feels okay, do that. So as we reach back, to more of a reclined position. Especially if you're propped up a little bit higher, you'll experience a little bit more chest opening out of that. If you get a little bit lower, you might feel a nice stretch in your left thigh hip area. We'll chill out here for a little bit and we'll let the pose work its magic as we breathe. This pose, or really any of our yin shapes, you might feel like you need to adjust something as things start to settle and acclimate. So listen to those signals and adjust accordingly. So just be extra careful as you come up from your reclined position, right? Don't rush it. Take a moment, okay? You can move your props from behind you. So from here, that half saddle leg, I'm gonna take out of that position and cross it over into a half shoelace position. So I'm gonna step my leg over and then kind of walk that foot back toward the right hip until the leg is resting down as much as it can, right? You could have a pillow or something in between your belly and your leg. This leg is extended forward for here. So as we start to lean forward a little bit and fold, You might feel any number of things. Some back stretch. You may feel some things in your hips. Probably also feeling some stretch on the back of that bottom leg. So we'll hang out here for a little bit. If you wanted to put something down to rest your head on, absolutely, you can try that as well. Take just a few more deep breaths here. Okay. Let's slowly walk it up out of that fold. Take a moment and then we'll uncross that left leg. Take a moment and then we have a whole set of poses on the other side. So we might just kind of have those props handy. Okay, so we're going to take our windshield wipers over to the left for that deer pose shape. Feet can be a little bit closer in, further away. Right, adjust that as needed for whatever reason, for how your body's feeling. That could be knees or hips or any number of things. Okay, from here we'll start with our neck stretch in that deer pose position. So left ear drops toward the left shoulder. Left hand reaches up and over. See if you can get behind your right ear. Little tug. Maybe a little change of position, and then we'll reach the right hand, back of the hand behind the back, so in the lower back area. Breathing. Try to relax your jaw. I had to remind myself of that. Okay, we'll release the neck stretch and go into that fold. So you might like to have some kind of prop out in front of you. All right, just kind of walking it forward, adjusting as needed. Maybe you keep your head up for a little bit of time. Maybe you decide at some point to put your head down. You can adjust the height of your prop. You can adjust leg position depending on how that feels. Okay, breathing. Just a couple more deep breaths here. This opposite leg might be in any number of ways, but down you bent, leg extended. I forgot to say this on the other side, but you can absolutely pad your ankle, right? Because that's a pretty big ankle stretch. And then from here, we're going to go into our reclined somewhat position, depending on your body. Prop it up as much as you need to. Lie all the way down if that feels good.
For half saddle.
Right, with props, probably feeling some nice chest opening, hopefully a little thigh hip stretch on the right side from that saddle leg. And breathe. Adjusted, however your body needs you to adjust, paying attention to that as we hold.
gentle as we come back up. Take a moment. And then we'll take that saddle leg out of position, and you can extend the other leg forward if it wasn't, and we'll step that right foot to the outside of the left leg and try to walk it over for that half shoelace position. Right, maybe you want something in between your leg and your belly. Lean forward until you feel some stretch. And breathe. Okay, just a few more deep breaths here. All right, walking up out of that half shoelace fold. Let's just take a moment, uncross, let things settle. And then from here, let's come down to our bellies. We're gonna do one little upper body stretch here. Take your time. All right. From here, I'm gonna take my left arm out to the left and then a little bit higher up, sort of at a diagonal. And I'm kind of trying to walk it as far away from the rest of my body as I can. I'm gonna take my right hand beside my chest, and I'm gonna keep kind of inching those fingers forward as I roll to the left. And you can decide to keep your head up or down or rested on something. Your top leg can stay stacked. It can be straight or bent or behind you. Breathing, feeling this maybe in that left shoulder a bit, in the left chest muscles. Okay. Let's slowly roll down. And take that over to the other side. Right arm reaches out and up a little bit, sort of at a diagonal, inching forward, rolling over. Decide where you want to put your head and your top leg, just depending on how that feels. Let's roll back down. And then carefully we'll press up and take a moment in child's pose. You might use your bolster to rest on. I'm gonna just do legs together. You know, and be a little bit more rounded and soft here. You could do arms down by your sides or arms forward. Try a couple different positions just to experiment and see what your body's needing after some of those poses, right?
To our backs, and you might not need a prop, you might decide you want one, so just make sure you've got things handy, just in case. Okay, so once you're down, I'm going to revisit one of the stretches we did with the block at the beginning of class, but this time without the block. So I'm going to grab, this time I'm going to grab the front side of my right knee instead of behind, but you can do whichever you like. As we slide the left leg down, give a nice pull in towards your chest, maybe a little bit of ankle rolling on that side. Into a twist, and you might decide you want to prop your leg up, so you know, just be aware. We're going to take that right knee over to the left and roll to the side of the left hip. So maybe you want to put something under your leg if it's not going down comfortably. It doesn't have to go all the way down, it just kind of depends on how it feels, right? And you can have that prop anywhere under your leg if you want it there. You can reach your opposite arm out to the side. You can look over the opposite shoulder or not. Both arms might reach out. You might keep your left hand as like a little weight on top of that leg, which I think feels nice.
couple more deep breaths. Okay, so we'll carefully, slowly roll back down. Maybe another hug on that right knee. Okay, and we'll switch sides, taking the right leg down and giving the left knee a hug in toward the chest. Again, you can reach behind the knee if that feels better. Maybe a little ankle rolling. For a twist, you can decide if you want to prop things up. You can reach your left arm out, right arm can be out too, or right hand can kind of weight your leg a little bit. Right, you can turn and look over the opposite shoulder, which is definitely what we traditionally do in our twist, but mix it up a little bit if you like. I find it it can affect how other things feel, which is always really interesting to me, especially for something fairly gentle like this. Looking in different directions affects how things feel, so experiment as needed. Couple more deep breaths. Okay, let's slowly, carefully come back down to our backs. Maybe another hug on that left knee. All right. From here, it's time for Shavasana. I highly recommend experimenting with propping your legs up. Feels awesome. So maybe some pillows or blocks under your legs, under your knees, approximately knees, thighs, blankets, bolster, etc. Anything can work. Okay, so let's just take a moment to settle in here. Close your eyes. And just scan your body and make sure things feel comfortable. Make sure everything has space. Check your neck and shoulders. Relax your jaw, your face. And just let go of your breath. Let it be natural and effortless. And let yourself rest. Start to deepen the breath and wiggle fingers and toes. Let's circle wrists and ankles. And a nice long stretch by reaching arms overhead, reaching through fingertips through the toes. Give the knees a hug and rock. And roll over to your side, resting there. Very gently press up to a seated position. Close your eyes and bring your hands together at your heart. And just take another scan of your body and notice how everything's feeling. Thank you so much for joining me for this Feel Good Yin practice today. And I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Namaste.